Tibet, Asia's mystery, photographed for the first time in 1923.
The more that I learned about what went on in my country, the angrier I got. I got involved with Students for Free Tibet for a lot of reasons. I mean, first off being that I'm Tibetan. I remember just hating what China did to my country and what they did to my people, and I took it personally, you know, because it's my family.
Long ago, Tibetans were very warlike. They controlled much of Asia, similar to the Mongolians. When Buddhism came to their country, they pretty much transformed the entire culture to be nonviolent and respectful of all life.
People who had been formerly in the military then became monks.
Tibet was a demilitarized country since the 17th century. The current 21st century world should be demilitarized countries, and economically bonded and living under a common rule of law where nations obey the law just as individuals do. We have not yet reached that world. The Tibetans reached it way ahead of us, and therefore naturally they were slapped around as a pawn because they didn't have an army.
When the Chinese marched into Lhasa, they shelled the Patala Palace for 3 days and killed 12,000 Tibetans as a result. And after the shelling ended, they imprisoned thousands more Tibetans. The 20 years after 1959 were like a black hole in Tibet's history. China's Cultural Revolution coincided with China's takeover of Tibet. And really, the way it manifested itself there was horrible, because every single act was like a desecration of Tibet's culture. During that time, China destroyed 6,000 of Tibet's monasteries, including the three major monasteries, Ganden, Sera, and Drepung. That was all an attempt to destroy the heart of Tibet, which is religion. The Dalai Lama is both the spiritual and political leader of the Tibetan people. Now more than ever, since we're in the situation that we are, he embodies the entire country. He, in his own lifetime, has attained such a high level of spirituality, and just knowing that there is someone out there who exists like that is such an inspiration.
Here I enjoy the freedom of speech, freedom of thought, freedom of movement. You, this nation, I think very much, you see, involved, or very much has cherish, you see, these principles. However, you see, when I was about 15, I lost that freedom.
In 1959, the Dalai Lama escaped into exile and has not returned since. He now lives in Dharamsala, India, with over 100,000 other refugees waiting to return home.
First time I started really, that I was really exposed to Tibetan culture, I was in Nepal, and I was trekking in the Himalayas, and I met some Tibetan refugees that had just come over the mountains. They were on their way to India to meet the Dalai Lama, and they explained that they weren't gonna go back to Tibet until Tibet was free. The more I got involved with the Tibetan cause, I just started realizing that the only way a change is going to come about is through spreading awareness, because our government isn't going to take a stand unless they're forced to. Our corporations aren't going to take a stand unless they're forced to. And so the only way that the change is going to come about is through mass public awareness. And the area that I'm able to help out with that is through music.
Milarepa was founded originally with royalties that came from the publishing from two songs we'd done on the Ill Communication album.
they wanted to have a vehicle from which to actively support these causes. He asked me if I would do it, and I said, if we're going to do it, let's do it right. Let's start an organization.
In addition to putting together the whole Tibetan Freedom Concert, the Milarepa Fund is also responsible for a couple of public service announcements, an educational documentary, all in this teeny office run entirely by 20-something-year-olds. So all of the organizing and all of the setup for the Tibetan Freedom Concert happens here?
Pretty much.
It must be just daunting and terrifying sometimes.
Yeah, well, it helps a lot that we don't know what we're doing, so we don't get as freaked out as we probably should.
I'm Maria Ma.
I'm the janitor.
I'm commander.
There are no titles in this thing, man.
And we're just trying to deal with the photographers, TV, electronic media.
When I first started getting involved in the Free Tibet movement, it brought up a lot of questions for me because I'm Chinese American. And I remember going to see my parents and asking them, you know, what's going on with Tibet? And to them, the idea of Free Tibet was, I guess, something that had never occurred to them because they had grown up always learning or being taught that Tibet belongs to China. But for me, I think whether or not you believe that Tibet has ever been a part of China or not, to me it's irrelevant because it's a question of self-determination. It's a question of people having the right to choose the kind of government they want, to choose their leaders, to choose the way they want to live their lives.
Gonna be a stupa in the middle of the concert. The stupa represents the Buddha and the Buddha's enlightened mind. These are the two headers for the big stages, right? And in the middle will be this part. And on the back of each of these will be the Tibetan national flag, which is illegal to have in Tibet. A couple of summers ago when we were up in Tibet, people would like run through the square with the flag just for 15 seconds just to have the flag out there, and they would get arrested, thrown in jail, sometimes for a couple years, you know, beaten, tortured. I mean, it's, you know, that's what happens up there. That's what's happening right now.
Francisco avait lieu le Tibetan Freedom Concert, un concert bénéfice pour sensibiliser les gens à la situation.
It was hard to find a sponsor. Why did you do it here in
Tibetan Freedom Concert, live from San Francisco to you this Saturday and Sunday.
Hi Jeff, it's Maria Mine. You faxed me regarding the concert? Yeah. Yeah, I just wanted to get back to you to let you know that I'm doing press for the Tibetan Freedom Concert, not the Tahitian Freedom Concert. Tibetan, T-I-B-E-T-A-N.
Welcome to the Tibetan Freedom Concert. I'd first like to introduce everybody. This is Tribe Called Quest, Anna Sui, Professor Bob Thurman, Björk, Adam Yauch, Yoko Ono, Richie Havens, and then De La Soul. And this is Gen Paulden Gyatso, and his interpreter Alan Wallace.
My name is Paulden Gyatso. In 1959, there was a rising of tens of thousands of Tibetans in Lhasa, the capital of Tibet. I was imprisoned for 33 years in Tibet. We were virtually starved to death. We were given hardly any food at all, so we were compelled to eat grass, whatever kind of insects, even a Chinese vomit or human excrement. There would even be some prisoners who got so hungry, just starving to death, they would even eat this.
Their swords would, come on their limbs by being suspended from the ceiling, and then they would have fires lit underneath them. And then from 1987 on, there was also electrical torture inflicted upon the Tibetans in these prisons. We'll show you some of these cattle prods that were used on him and all of the female prisoners. These are the cattle prods. These were smuggled out of Tibet. These are the actual instruments that were used in his prison. These would be plugged in, so they're completely electrified. There's a button here that would be pushed, and then sparks would be emitted from this end here. 13th of October, 1990, was the worst experience he'd had in terms of torture. In this case, these cattle prods were stuck into his mouth. And as a result of this, he lost all of his teeth. And again, for the nuns, including the nun sitting to my left, then this nun here has experienced this. They were actually raped with these electrical torture instruments. This is the documentation verifying, again his own incarceration for 33 years. This is the Chinese documentation demonstrating that he was, in fact, incarcerated for 33 years in Tibet. Please bear in mind that this is not a unique or unusual circumstance. This is ongoing torture that is taking place now. Please bear this in mind and do whatever you can to alleviate the suffering of the Tibetan people.
Tibetans try to live their lives in a nonviolent way, but monks and nuns especially, because they have to take these vows of nonviolence when they enter their orders.
Phonsong Yaki, a 20-year-old Tibetan nun and prisoner of conscience, died in a police hospital.
Damcho Pemo miscarried a week after police beat her with electric batons.
There were 12 girls like me. I was only 14 years old. That night, several Chinese officers began ripping off my clothes. I couldn't make them stop. Then I was raped by three officers.
He was not given any food or water during the interrogation. An electric baton was put in his mouth. His hands were cuffed diagonally behind his back, while bottles were struck behind his elbows, and after a few minutes, his arms lost all feeling.
Your Holiness, do you hate the Chinese?
No. Almost not. Sometimes I lose some temper, but almost none, any hatred feeling. And instead, see, afterward, I get to see more concern, more compassion towards them. And in my daily prayer, there's some certain practice we call exchange or take and give. You see, my positive mental thought is give them through imagination. You see, take their ignorance and their suffering, their anger, their hatred. You see, take it into myself. So that kind of practice I seriously do.
Fighters. Today we are the Freedom Fighters.
Visiting is pretty, visiting is good. Seems that all I ever wanted was a morning. There's to be a secret. We can keep it good.
for?
For Tibet.
Hey, for Tibet?
Yeah.
You know about Tibet?
Yeah, kind of.
Kind of? Did you just find out about it today?
No, I knew about it for like a month.
What's your impression of American youth based on the concert goers?
It's very good. I like. Thank you.
They don't scare you with the moshing and like the way they dance. You know, when they bump into each other in the, it's called a mosh.
Yes, sometimes I'm surprised. The others pushing and sometimes they throw on the people's. Sometimes surprising, so they are not fighting, but they are very happy. I like it.
I invited him for a birthday present.
I'm coming here with him.
What
did you think
about what's going
on in Tibet?
They, like, captured or something.
What?
I don't know.
A
funny.
Yeah,
I'm not here.
Hey.
Hey.
How you doing?
Can you tell us what your job is to do here today?
Right now it's to pass out these, which is the flyers for the programs for the concert. We're also in there trying to get signatures for the petition to Bill Clinton.
Do people seem like they're something they're interested in reading?
It's about half and half.
Come on! Yes, come on! Yeah, yeah. You're digging the sound! You're digging the sound! Check it out! Digging the sound coming from plug, 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 plug. You're digging the sound! You're digging the sound coming from plug, 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 plug. You're digging the sound!
To express peace and express respect for the next individual. So why not take it to the next level and, you know, express it in, about how it's going on in different lands and how it should be in different lands, you know? So we're definitely just trying to bring it back home to our neighborhood and let people know what we've seen and what we've heard.
Hey, Mom, how you doing?
Awesome.
have an effect on the people that have come out?
It's making people aware of what's going on, you know. It's better than nothing, you know.
Yeah.
But the interesting thing is, it doesn't seem like anyone's really caring about it. Like, yesterday when that guy was talking about it, I was like talking to people and people weren't like affected by it.
Really?
They were like lethargic and dead, you know. It's like, what's wrong with America, you know? It's like people aren't really inspired by what's really going on.
What was he saying?
Tibet. Well, he was talking about how he's tortured and stuff and how women are raped and like all those horrible things that are happening in Tibet.
Cool.
Wanted to enjoy ourselves.
I'll tell you why, man. That guy was talking for days. That's why, you know.
Yeah.
You know, I care and everything, but you know, short attention spans.
See, because I think it's a selfish thing. Actually, I think America's not involved in the thing. No one close to like American people are being affected by it. So who gives a shit? Which drives me crazy. I was walking around and I was hearing all this negative energy like directed at people that were really towards the Free Tibet thing.
I mean, the Tibetans are just, they're nonviolent. And so anybody that has a vengeance is going to take whatever they want from them. And people that are stronger can't allow that to happen.
Tibetan Buddhist consciousness is not just about world peace and everybody loving one another, but it's about having individuals having calmness within themselves and being peaceful within themselves so that, you know, in turn, everyone would be kind to each other naturally. I'm just really lucky and happy to play here today for something that means a lot to me.
Yo, yo, Roswell.
Yo, yo,
did you make it off the plane, Roswell?
Yo, yo,
you made it off the plane, Roswell.
In Nepal, the kids, they were really similar, like the things we do every day, it was same, things we talk about, same.
Really?
Yeah.
How old are you?
I'm 17 years old.
And so were you listening to the same kind of music and stuff?
Uh-huh, we were listening to the same kind of music. I brought some of my music there and they liked it, so it was cool.
What do you like?
I like the Fugees.
Ooh, la, la. It's the way that we rock when we're doing our thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, la, la,
come on,
la.
Come on.
It's the natural, not only Frisco.
See, I've imagined this much more traditional kind of way of being.
No, not at all for the kids. Maybe for the older people.
We used to be number 10. Now we have it in one. In the back, I lost my finger. Mike became my heart, pistol, nozzle, and tenazel. Blood becomes a warm. Tell them, move my knees and I'll squeeze the shot. That's why clutch. See that flesh gets scorched. You so bad, make you feel like you ain't wanna be born. John. And tell your friends that the hell out of my lawn. To the tickets for my war.
Yeah.
I got the dead pigeon. If you're my fiancé, then I'm bringing my head to Sicilian. Nobody shoot, my body's made of hand grenade. Now I'm led to death while she was hunkers in the razor blade. That sounds sick, everywhere they outright the horror. Black killer comes to the ghetto, pick him up, Jackson Acura. Stevie Wonder sees crack babies becoming enemies of their own family. I'ma get it, come, you know what we do. Gun by my side, just in case I got a rum. A boy on the side of Babylon, trying to front like a devil on Zion.
China has been rewriting Tibet's history since way before they took over the country. And I think that's why a lot of Chinese people from the mainland and also those who are here really do believe that Tibet is a part of China. But if you really look at the facts, you will understand that Tibet has always been an independent country and that our relationship with China has been one of a neighbor. There are two major reasons why China is so interested in Tibet. The first one is a very strategic location in Asia. It's right between China and the other major country in Asia, which is India. And its altitude being 12 to 14,000 feet, it also serves as a great site for launching nuclear missiles, of which they have many stationed in Tibet right now. China's got about 17 radar stations They have 14 military airfield bases and 5 nuclear bases with at least 18 ICBMs, 75 medium range and 20 intermediate missiles. The other reason is that China suffers from overpopulation, and they've absorbed a number of other smaller countries surrounding them. Tibet is just one of them. Inner Mongolia and East Turkestan are two others.
So what are you here today doing? What's your job here?
I'm doing photos.
Taking photos?
I'm taking pictures.
For what?
For interview magazine.
Are you French?
I am French. I'm very French.
Well, my name is Pierre. I came from France to cover the Beastie Boys. I'm a big fan of Björk, Yoko Ono. I love all this music, all this type of thing, you know.
I'm very happy. I have banana, everything is great.
We have a mobile television. We are covering it for all of France, you know, from all the way in Lyon up to the far north, the Alps, the Upper Zell.
Is he out nervous?
No. No, just me. I've decided to take all the nervous tension off to myself.
Like the music?
Yes, very good.
What bands in particular? Do you remember the names at all?
Yesterday, there's the one Pizza T, Pizza, Pizza, Pizza.
Peter?
Pizza Boy, Pizza Boy.
Pizza Boy?
Smashing
Pumpkins?
No, Smashing Pumpkins. They're called the Pizza or?
Beastie Boy.
Beastie Boy, yes.
Yeah,
Beastie
yeah.
Boy.
You like the Beastie Boy?
Yes.
Students for Free Tibet is a grassroots level organization made up of students from universities and high schools all over the country. Well, there are a number of chapters all over the country that have already been started, but if there isn't one at your university, I think
starting an SFT chapter would be great.
There's going to be a demonstration this Monday. There's going to be a demonstration on Monday. There's a demonstration on Monday.
So a lot of people committing acts of civil disobedience. A bunch of us are going to just, you know, lie down there in front of the Chinese mission and protest.
Well, I hope they don't lock us up too long. I got work the next day.
The more students we can get involved behind this cause, the better, because I think students really have the power. They did so much for South Africa. I just hope that they can do the same for Tibet.
Laws and oppressing the Tibetan people.
Do you have any message you'd like to give out to the Chinese government?
Do you know Chinese?
No.
I don't know Chinese either. I just want to say leave those poor Tibetan people alone.
guys. Hey, how's it going?
So, here is Adam Horowitz from Beastie Boys. And I have a couple questions. So, what do you think about Tibet?
What do I think about Tibet? Well, I think about it. I think of a place.
Me too. I was thinking about
it. Yeah, I think about it. I've never been there, so I can just only think about it.
Exactly, me too.
Yeah.
Tibetan Buddhism very much involved in training of mind, not as a religion, but rather as a certain method or certain technique to improve one's mind. Therefore, I think the Tibetan tradition have some potential to contribute for the benefit of humanity.
Buddha taught us that if we let our desire of wealth and fame govern our lives, that we'll be caught in this endless cycle of suffering. And his teachings, simply stated, they tell us to have compassion for all things.
Buddha, he experienced on that and he got enlightened. So he said, I've been through this, 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 and I got this result. If you want it, you can check, test it. If you think it's really, then you follow me.
Does the Buddhist believe in like karma and reincarnation?
Karma is like this. If you throw a stone up in the sky, it's not going to stay there long. It always
it's come back down.
Same. If you've done good deeds, your karma will turn around.
It's going to come back down.
It's always like that.
But good karma result brings you happiness, and negative actions brings you unhappiness.
That's why I call love and compassion is a universal religion. One's own happiness and joy depend on others. So therefore, in order to achieve one's own happiness, you should take care. You should have to serve other people. You see, creates more happiness on other people, then ultimately you get the benefit.
What's going on in there?
We're making a sand painting.
Sand painting, I don't know if you can see it.
Normally it takes 2 weeks to build this, but since they had 2 days to do it, but they're doing an abbreviated version of just the centerpiece. They use this to help you to visualize during meditation, what you're trying to accomplish. For example, emptying your mind and so forth. But at the end, after the teaching is over, they sweep the sand all up and then destroy it.
That's it, huh?
Yes. You develop your mind and your soul rather than being attached to material things.
This tune is called No More Kings, and it's very appropriate today.
Pilgrims, they sail the sea, try to find a place of their own, so free in their little ship. The Mayflower, they hope for FFFG, so home. They finally knocked on Plymouth Rock, and someone said, hey, we're there!
I've been a bit obsessed about the Tibet thing since I was a teenager. I wrote this massive essay on it when I was 16 in school. Coming from a country with only 280,000 people, and we're always obsessed with the little minority groups that have been oppressed by bigger things or bigger nations. We watched cowboy and Indian films when I was a kid, and we always supported the Indians and fuck the cowboys. And I guess I got that kind of sort of upbringing.
I become a nun because when I was very small, I really admired the monks and nuns. So all the time I used to say to my father, I wanted to become a nun, and at last I became a nun. She became a nun because she said it benefits this life as well as next life. They participated in the peaceful demonstration in Klesa. 3 times she went to prison. First time she stayed 1 month and 3 days. Second time she stayed 11 months. And third time she stayed almost 5 months. After 5 months, then she...
The struggle to free Tibet has really been a nonviolent struggle.
There's a famous Buddhist verse that his holiness always teaches. When someone beats you with a stick, you don't hate the stick. You don't hate the arm that swung the stick. And it isn't even Mao who's wielding the stick. It's diluted ideology. It's the flow of history. It's the confused karma. It's like a whole series of things going way back, you know? You don't hate them. If anything, you hate the hatred that is making them behave like that with you. And of course, the hate the hatred is like one of those paradoxes. Then that means you can't hate.
It takes a long time, but it gets you there. You know, because any goal that we achieve through violence or through harming, then it's not the, you know, the result is not worth it. So the means is very important too.
We are having protests on 17th, that's on Monday, at 11:30 a.m. in Chinese consulate, and we really need your support.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay.
How many people do you think will come?
Two.
Huh?
Me and you.
I'll be there. That's three.
It's really cool that you're here. And we're here for the same reason. The people of Tibet.
The world is a vampire!
We'll be right back.
I'm Anna Sui, and I'm a clothing designer.
My family is from China, but I was born in the United States. My parents left China and had no country to return to. There's so many things that we grow up with that we take for granted. People around the world don't have the same privileges that we do and the same advantages. And when I started looking and noticing that, I don't know that they make baseball caps in the USA anymore. I mean, they're from Honduras, they're from the Philippines, they're from every place but this country. I think that, you know, the cost of labor is just too expensive here, where labor is cheap in China. When there's a large company that has a product that's selling to a lot of people, that's usually what they have to do, is find the lowest cost. It's the bigger corporations that really have to start using their force and their power to get the government to honor human rights. You know, we think, oh, great, it's a, you know, $4 baseball cap, not, oh my God, this is a government that doesn't allow human rights, that don't allow people to worship the way they want to worship.
How people were paying attention today, for instance, as compared to when the monks were with us on tour on Lollapalooza, and nobody paid attention then. And just in the span of like 3 years, a lot more people have become aware and they're paying attention. So
yeah, we live in an environment where, you know, 3 years, you know, it's not a big deal, right? But when 3 years, when you're being oppressed, it probably seems like a lifetime.
When I'm done, we're going to show him how to do the beatbox. He's going to show me, all right?
All right. Okay, cool. So we'll be back. Don't leave.
Okay, from yo, I want every everybody on this side to go free, right? On the strength of the do-rag. And I want this side to go Tibet to what I'm getting ready to do, all right? Go free Tibet, free Tibet, free Tibet. Keep going.
What are you? You're exploiting this young man.
Julian, don't let yourself get exploited.
We're having fun, aren't we?
This is a global village, as you know, and everything that happens in this village affects us directly. And I think it's beautiful that the citizens in this country are starting to be caring about the Oriental people. I mean, you know, this is like a start, isn't it? You know, I think it's great.
China is the most rapidly growing export market for the United States.
I am moving, therefore, to de-link human rights from the annual extension of most favored nation trading status for China.
You guys get a chance to sign a letter to the president?
What am I signing for?
It's a letter supporting human rights in China and Tibet and telling President Clinton that you're disappointed that he renewed most favored nation trading status for China.
Dear Mr. President, 30,000 of the participants signed the enclosed letter to you. Each signature represents an individual asking you to support Tibet.
For Tibet!
We, the people of America, call on you as a world leader and as President of the United States to act now. I will continue to speak out until there is concrete evidence that you are not double-talking around the issues, but acting to change them.
I don't think he's going to read it. I don't really think he cares.
it's hard to expect real serious intentions with any sort of free-form rock concerts with millions of kids, but I think, you know, just raising awareness and some of the speeches were really nice. I think that's about the best, I don't know, that dumb rock stars can do.
You know, unfortunately, America needs stars to make something happen. And so if kids see their stars talking about awful things happening in Tibet, then maybe they'll pay attention and learn about it themselves and go further with it.
If this cause were attached to, like, money, like oil, like Kuwait was, you know, I'm sure America would already be there, you know, like, bombing the hell out of them. But since it's a country we're materially relying on, and politically relying on, you know, we Americans don't do anything about it.
But I mean, look at, you know, as many people are here, if even like a third of them got something, then it'd be a start.
Well, as you can see, it's just me.
She took back her love and she put it out into the sun. The birds did fly when the heavens all went dry, and the cigarettes were smoking by themselves. She'll do anything. She'll do.
Thanks.
I'm kind of amazed, you know, how devoted the people are to their musicians. You know, that, you know, the scene like this were, you know, compares to like how Tibetans would attend a big spiritual event, you know, kind of rushing in to get the best seat and everything, you know. So for us, this would be something that would happen with our spiritual teachers like His Holiness.
How did you first become aware of the problems in Tibet?
Adam Yauch from the Beastie Boys brought it to our attention. He brought us a video cassette of some of the torture and of some of the prisoners. You know, it was just, after that, it was just like clear, you know, what our mission was, what our involvement was supposed to be.
Since the 1949 invasion and occupation of Tibet, 6,000 monasteries have been destroyed.
Forced abortion and sterilization of Tibetan women is common.
Hundreds of Tibetans have been in prison
for taking part in peaceful demonstrations.
If a prisoner dies while being beaten,
it's the prisoner's fault.
Sound familiar?
But once again, fight.
Anybody of any nationality could probably look into their own history, into their own country's history, and see something similar. It's not like the world has not seen something like this happen before. I mean, Americans can look into their own history and look at what happened to the Native Americans, because they looked at Native Americans as being barbarians, which is exactly the same approach China's taken to Tibet.
Brute force, no matter how strongly applied,
can never subdue the basic human desire for freedom and dignity.
Free Tibet.
Yeah! Don't know what time it is. When I say, can I kick it? I want all y'all to say yes to care. Fuck the bullshit.
I want all y'all to say
yes to care. Jump. Higher. Come on, y'all. Can y'all kick it? your mic, let your shit rip.
I am a fully demonstration of my ass, I am. Tell your mommy, tell your daddy, send a telegram. I'm like an energizer, come to see your last song. Two is never ever right because we stand strong. And you say no silence like us when you're dead wrong.
I say that body and else again, no, they push it along.
You're a fool to remind and fight for shots of air. Cause you know, and I know, that you know who I am.
You I am.
I'm too tired of these cause I don't my love to see. And a little finger goes for all your poker teeth. Cause I love it when you act at me to spicy.
They get vexed up on this, just like a test me. Come on. It must be a wreck. Where we at?
Frisco, you got to.
Where we at?
Everybody, Frisco, you got to.
Where we at?
Sacramento, Oaktown, you know you got to.
Where we
the
at?
The whole Bay Area in the hand.
Yo, yo, yo. Check the vibe, yo.
What?
Here we go, yo.
What?
Check the vibe, yo.
Huh?
Here we go, yo.
Huh?
Check the vibe, yo.
Huh?
Check it out.
Check it out.
Check it out.
It's Frisco.
Check the vibe, yo. Oh.
Are you enjoying today?
More than enjoying today. This is a perfect day. A perfect day. And for all reasons.
How's this day going for you as far as shows go?
Can't hear a word you're saying.
How's the show going for you?
Good, good. Very peaceful.
Yeah, there's no problem whatsoever.
Yeah. There's a lot of good music to listen to. And they seem to be having fun.
Wow, 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 wow
Dozens of Tibetan freedom supporters gathered outside the Chinese consulate in San Francisco today. Exiled Tibetans, union leaders, and Buddhist monks joined a protest against President Clinton's renewal of China's most favored nation trade status. They also want a boycott of all Chinese goods coming into the U.S.
I am the Tibetan nun who was incarcerated in your prison. I have too have been subject to the torture. You strip us naked. You torture us. You sexually violate us. You pour boiling water over our skins. This torture we know is going on to this day. This is part of your present policy. Just last month, monks from the Ganden Monastery outside a plaza peacefully demonstrated. You shot them down in the street, and you imprisoned, you threw more into concentration camps. This was just last month. We have come to this demonstration not out of aggression, not out of violence. We wish you no harm. We are coming because we cannot bear the tragedy that you are perpetuating in Tibet. The suffering is too great. So for our compassion for the victims of your brutality, this is why we have come. In conclusion, this is what we request of you, the Chinese government. His Holiness the Dalai Lama, our leader, the leader of all Tibetans, is simply asking, sit down at the negotiating table with him or his representatives, discuss the situation of Tibet, acknowledge what is going on there, and make headway for human rights and freedom for Tibetans in Tibet.
Want to stay here, you will be arrested. You all understand that? We advise you all individually, and you can make your decision as we approach. Right?
I think that Students for Free Tibet has the capability of being a great force in this movement. I remember as a student that I was constantly reading about horrible things that had happened in the past, you know, and people regretted it, but, you know, here it is happening right now. You don't need to regret it, you can just do something. Now is the time, and Tibet is the perfect way to right so many wrongs that have gone on in the past.
tell you how delighted I am that you at the Milarepa Foundation have been able to bring together tens of thousands of people for this Tibetan cause. For the 33 years that I was in the concentration camp, I prayed to the Buddha, Dhamma, and Sangha, our objects of refuge. I prayed that one day there would be a day like this. And so now my happiness goes beyond all expression. And so I can die in peace. And so from my side, I will offer prayers that the United States government can continue to progress. They can become more and more enlightened in their policies and their view, and that there may be only increasing prosperity for all American people. And so as a symbol of my gratitude to all of you at the Milarepa Foundation, I'd like to offer each of you as well a kata, an offering scarf. I ask you, please continue in your efforts.